Just 20 years after the invention of airplane by Wright brothers, air travel became a usual thing to do. When Apple launched its first iPhone in 2007, within the next 10 to 15 years, smartphone became an everyday used gadget. Currently, more than 40% of the world's population is using smartphones. It is interesting how the things which people once thought would be impossible to invent have become a part of our daily lives. It just takes one courageous innovator with an idea to disrupt any industry. Elon Musk is one of those rare innovators who has disrupted three industries in his lifetime: the space industry, the finance, and the automobile industry. Today, we are going to see his inventions and some interesting things about them. Hi guys, this is Prateek and you are watching Eclectic, and welcome to the inventions of Elon Musk. The Hyperloop. Elon Musk and his SpaceX team presented a white paper on Hyperloop. Elon made the concept open sourced and said anyone interested can take the idea further to develop it. Hyperloop would be the fastest way to travel. Passengers will sit in pods that travel at airline speed through pressurized tubes using electric propulsion and magnetic levitation.
Imagine traveling non-stop at up to 670 miles per hour, above land or underground. This is Hyperloop, a new mode of transportation that has been developed by Hyperloop One. It starts with an electric motor, which is broken up into two basic components: the rotor, which rotates, and the stator, which is stationary. The stator is an electromagnet, so when an electric current passes through it, the rotor is magnetically attracted to spin. Unlike a normal electric motor, the Hyperloop One motor isn't circular, it's linear. And the rotor is on the pod, which is propelled magnetically as it moves over the stator. Hyperloop One's unique technology uses magnetic levitation to guide and lift the pod off the track. Nearly all of the air inside the Hyperloop tube is removed using a series of vacuum pumps. This effectively creates our own sky inside the tube, as if you are quietly flying at 200,000 feet above sea level. This reduces drag, so only the smallest amount of electricity is needed to achieve extraordinary speeds, and creates a more cost and energy efficient system than high-speed rail or airline transport. Hyperloop One will be automated by the most advanced systems in the world, allowing a safe and efficient journey that's never delayed or overbooked. Hyperloop is the first new form of public transportation in over 100 years.
It can complete the journey of several hours in a matter of minutes. When Elon first presented this concept, many people criticized it and said it is science fiction. However, now Hyperloop is about to become a reality. Hyperloop has already completed its first successful test ride. Groups of students around the world are working on Hyperloop. However, the world's first commercial Hyperloop will be launched in Abu Dhabi by the next year.
We are very excited to premiere our Virgin Hyperloop One passenger experience at the Dubai World Expo 2020. We know that our system will be the backbone of the smart mobility revolution, and Expo visitors will be the very first to see it. This experience will give future customers the chance to interact with the pods, which will mirror the experiences that they're going to see in commercial operations.
The next one is a tunnel project. The tunnel project is about solving the traffic issue we face in our day-to-day lives. This is basically about the underground tunnel for the traffic to pass at high speed.
Okay, what you're looking at here is some pretty incredible video of what Elon Musk calls a product launch. The unveiling of his first tunnel came last night. His first completed subterranean route under Hawthorne, California. This is one of his ventures. It's called The Boring Company, as in dig, as in bore. And as Michael joins me, that's the whole idea. Yeah. He really hated LA traffic, and who doesn't? So he decided to just start digging.
Electric cars of Tesla Motors. An electric car is an old concept, but how Elon Musk is making them advanced is something we should admire. Tesla car is an amazing combination of electronics, automobile, and software. It is interesting how Tesla is making these electric cars mainstream. Tesla has a network of charging stations where Tesla owners can charge their car for free. Tesla has built more than 1200 supercharger stations with 10,000 superchargers around the world. 99% of the United States population is now within the 150 miles of a supercharger. Tesla car can travel more than 200 miles in a single charge. It means you can travel the whole United States by road without even spending a single dollar.
Tesla developed this supercharging technology, which is the most advanced charging technology in the world. This is something that allows you to make a brief stop at one of our Tesla supercharger stations, charge your car very quickly, and be on your way. Something that's unique about the supercharger is that it's free. It's not just free now, it's free forever. The number of Tesla supercharging stations is increasing dramatically. By the end of next month, we will have tripled the number of stations since the beginning of the year. Within 6 months, we will have covered most of the major metro areas of North America. A year from now, we will have covered 80% of the North American population, and within 2 years, over 98%. So by buying a Tesla, you essentially have free long distance travel throughout the country forever.
Tesla's cheapest model, Tesla Model 3, is priced at $35,000. Let me tell you an interesting story about electric cars in Norway. Norway is full of Teslas. In Norway, Tesla holds a record for the most number of cars sold in a single month. So why Norway is full of Teslas? 99% of Norway's electricity comes from hydropower. It means from dams and water. So they have very clean, cheap energy which can be used to power these electric cars. In addition, Norway's government gives incentives, subsidies and many free services to encourage people to buy an electric car. People get free parking. They get to drive on HOV lane which has very less traffic. People who have electric cars in Norway get a tax deduction on their income tax. In addition, people don't have to pay any registration fees to buy electric cars. And companies like Tesla don't have to pay sales tax in Norway. There are literally thousands of superchargers available in Norway for people to charge their electric cars for free.
Within the next 12 months, you're going to be seeing many of these, not only in Norway, but also in the rest of Europe, enabling customers to drive all over Europe free of charge.
The question is, why the government does all this? Norway is a huge producer of oil and gas, and they sell that to other countries and generate good revenue. They use the revenue they get from oil for funding these subsidies for electric cars. Norway sells their own oil to others because they don't want the pollution. Norway is determined to establish healthy pollution-free society, but the irony is, this is all dependent on the oil money they get from other countries. Now let us see the next invention, the solar city. Elon Musk is not a founder of solar city, however, he is the biggest shareholder of solar city. Lyndon Rive and Peter Rive are the founders of SolarCity. SolarCity is the largest solar service provider in the United States. SolarCity markets, manufactures and installs residential and commercial solar panels in the US. All the supercharger stations of Tesla are solar powered with the help of SolarCity. Tesla owns SolarCity. Tesla is planning to disconnect Tesla superchargers from electricity grid completely in the coming years. The next one is the Gigafactory. Gigafactory is what Elon Musk calls
giant machine that builds the machine.
Tesla's Gigafactory makes everything that Tesla sells. Batteries, home storage, solar panels, and of course electric cars. Gigafactory is large enough to house 107 NFL football fields. According to Elon's calculation, if we have 100 Gigafactories around the world, we can solve the world's energy problem. Gigafactory, with the help of Panasonic, also produces lithium-ion batteries. All Tesla cars have lithium-ion battery packs. Now here is an amazing example of basic economics by Elon Musk. From the very beginning, Tesla manufactured more than 80% of the components they need. But they could not manufacture batteries. Manufacturing batteries at a competitive price is very difficult. The largest three manufacturers of batteries, Panasonic, BYD and LG, combined make 63% of the world's batteries. Tesla has always bought batteries from Panasonic at the cost of about $200 per kilowatt hours. But that means Tesla's smallest battery pack version of 20 kilowatt hours can cost $10,000 just in components. When you are trying to manufacture a $30,000 car, $10,000 is a significant cost that can be reduced if Tesla starts manufacturing their own batteries. Therefore, Tesla and Panasonic made a deal, and now in joint venture, they mass produce these batteries at Tesla's Gigafactory. Now isn't that amazing example of Elon Musk's basic economics? Elon Musk believes in making his products accessible to middle class. That is why he constantly tries to bring down the prices of his products at his both companies, Tesla and SpaceX. Thank you all for watching. See you soon.